Good morning, students. In our previous class, we have started the lesson, The Lake That Blew Away. I have explained you how the brigands used to kill the passers-by and stain the lake in Estonia. Isn't it? So let's quickly look at some questions. So the first question is, what indication has the author given that the brigands had a brisk trade and were thriving? What indications has the author given? Their pockets jingled with gold and their gambling lasted all night. So this is the indication. Okay. The next question is, how can we infer that as a result of brisk trade, several lives were put to an untimely and gory end? So how you can say that because of their brisk trade, several lives were put to an end? Now, as you know, the bandits were brutal bunch. They would mercilessly murder pilgrims and merchants for money. They put many innocent life at risk. They cut their throat and threw the body into the dark waters of Lake Inn, and the blood stained the lake. Now, let's move further. In horror and disgust, the lake seethed and bubbles of marsh gas rose from the rotting weed on its bed. I will not be stained with the sin of these wicked men. I shall leave this place. Now, in horror and disgust, whatever sins were committed by the brigands, they were horrific. So because of the horror and disgust means a feeling of strong disapproval. The Lake Inn had the feeling of strong disapproval, and because of that, the lake seethed. Seethed means boiled. The water of the lake started boiling and bubbles of marsh gas rose from the rotting weeds on its bed. And the bubbles of marsh gas, it is a methane. Especially it is formed because of the rotten material. So as you know that the passers-by were killed and their bodies were thrown into the river, and because of that it got rotten. The weeds were rotten, and due to that a methane gas was produced and the lake started boiling. I will not be stained with the sin of these wicked men. I shall leave this place. So I will not be stained. I means here the Lake Inn. So Lake Inn said that she would not be stained with the sin which were committed by the brigands. And so the lake decided to leave that place and go away, move to the another place. The robber chief, staring in his sleep, heard the slack of water on the lake shore. Now the robber chief, staring in the sleep. Staring means causing excitement. So he was in sleep and it caused excitement. He heard a slack of water. Slap of water. See, when you row the boat, a certain sound of water is heard. That sound is called as slap. So the robber chief heard the slap of water on the lake shore. He heard a suck as of mud parting company from boot or a boat. Now this robber chief also heard a saksha. So it is also a sound when somebody sucks the liquid. Some sound is made, that is saksha. So the robber chief also heard the suction sound of mud parting. Parting means leaving. He heard the sound of mud leaving the company of boot or boat. Drops of water fell on the roof and he thought rain and turned over to see again. So some drops of water fell on this robber chief. He thought that it was raining and so again he went to sleep. Suddenly, hands were pulling at the covers and voices shouting in his ears, "Come quick, come quick, the lake is, well, it's the lake is." So after he went back to sleep again, he heard some voices. And he also felt the hands pulling his covers, whatever quilt he had taken to cover his body while sleeping. So somebody was pulling that cover and he also heard the voices. The voices said, "Come quickly." And the lake is, so he could not complete the sentence. "The lake is what?" demanded the robber chief, grabbing a bandit by the throat. So now the voices just said, "The lake is, the lake is, the lake is." So now the robber chief became angry. So he asked in anger, "What happened to lake? The lake is what?" And he grabbed the throat of one of the bandit and asked him to tell what had happened to the lake. "What is the lake doing that you wake me in the middle of the night?" So he asked, "What happened? What lake is doing? Why you have made me to wake up at late in the night?" It was late night and the bandit came and tried to wake the robber chief up. So the robber chief became angry. His sleep was disturbed and so he asked what the lake did, what happened to the lake that you are waking me up at this late hours at night. "Flying away, chief, like a carpet, chief." So the bandit said that the lake is flying away like a carpet. So how the carpet flies away? If you must have seen the serial Aladdin, you must have seen how the carpet flies in the sky. So he said to the robber chief that the lake was flying like a carpet in the sky. "Up and away, chief, all silver and glittering." So he said that the lake is flying up and it is going away. It is silver in color and it is glittering. Glittering means shining. So the lake looks silver and shining and it is going away from here. It is up in the sky. The robber chief rolled out of the bed and stumbled to the window. So now when he heard that the lake is flying away, the robber chief got up from his sleep and he stumbled to the window. Stumbled means to almost fell down. Suddenly when he woke up from his sleep, he lost his balance and he was about to fell down. So he stumbling, he went to the window to see what had happened. Overhead is the sky hung a billion gallons of water, shining like a metal plate, thick and cumulus clouds, spreading out to all points of compass, a transcendent ceiling, if it were to fall. Now, overhead in the sky hung a billion gallons of water. over head, above the head. Hung is the past tense of hang. So a billion gallons of water means here the lake Peene was hanging overhead in the sky, shining like a metal plate, thick as cumulus clouds. Now this lake, this large body of water was shining like a silver plate, thick as cumulus clouds. Now this silver plate was as thick as cumulus clouds. Now what do you mean by cumulus clouds? Means clouds forming rounded masses heaped on each other above a flat base at fairly low altitude. A group of clouds forming round masses at a flat base, that is called as cumulus clouds. So like cumulus clouds, this lake was seen floating in the sky. Spreading out to all points of the compass, a translucent ceiling. Now translucent means not completely transparent, but clear enough so that a light can pass through it. So that lake, it was not completely transparent, but it was clear so that light could pass through it. So it looked clear. It looked as if a translucent ceiling. If it were to fall, the bandit stood stock still, waiting for a billion steel gallons to fall on their heads like the end of the world. Now they had a question. What if this falls down? So the bandits, the robbers, they stood stock still. Stock still means motionless. They stood motionless. They did not move from their place. Waiting for a billion steely gallons to fall on their heads. Now they were waiting for this billion gallons to fall on their head. The lake to fall on their head. Like the end of the world. And they thought that if the lake falls on their head, it will be the end of their world. Minute after minute, they listened to the gentle hiss of moving water cascading through the sky. So minute after minute, each and every single minute, they could hear the hiss of moving water cascading through the sky. Cascading means falling or rushing forth in great quantity. So now you know that the lake was very deep and it had a large quantity of water. So this water was rushing forth and moving ahead. So while moving, it made a hiss sound. Then the moon bobbed into view again like a fishing float and the danger was past. Then after some time, the moon bobbed. Bobbed means here appeared. Now the moon was covered by this lake. Due to this lake, these bandits were not able to see the moon in the sky. They could see only the lake. But now as the lake moved ahead, now the moon was visible to them. The moon appeared in the sky and they thought that now the danger has passed. Well, what are you waiting for? Bellowed the robber chief. Then when the lake moved ahead, robber chief asked his bandits what they were waiting for. Bellowed means shouted in a roar. angrily shouted loudly, "What are you waiting for? Get out there and make the most of it. There will be fish by the barren loop too, there for the picking up. And treasure, don't forget the treasure, all there just for taking." So now he shouted loudly to the bandits that, "Why are you waiting here? Go ahead and make the most of it. Try to take whatever you can." He said that there will be fish, and go and pick up the fish. He also said that there will be treasure as well. So get all that treasure. Don't leave everything. Everything is for taking. As they pelted down to the lake, dawn was just rising. Now pelted. Pelted means moved rapidly here. The meaning of pelted here is moved rapidly. So all the bandits, they moved rapidly down the lake. At that time, the dawn was just rising. Dawn means the first ray of light that appears before the sunrise. So before the sunrise, the first ray of light, that is dawn, the time before sunrise is called as dawn. Its opposite is dusk. So it was the dawn. It was the time just before the sunrise. "The boats have gone, chief." So the bandits said that the boats have gone. There are no boats in the lake. The boats are missing. "Who needs them? We can walk." So the robber chief said that we don't need the boats. We can go walking. They plunged on up to their knees in mud. They plunged. Plunged means jumped energetically. So energetically jumped on their knees in the mud where the lake was situated. The lake bed was certainly alive with wriggling movement. So the lake bed, like lake bed means the place where there was a lake. So the lake bed was alive. It was wriggling. Wriggling means twisting and turning. And treasure chests lay about, smashed open at the hinges and steaming in the early sun. So they could also see the treasure chests lay out, smashed. Smashed means violently or badly broken or shattered. The treasure chests were shattered in the bed of Lake Inn. Open at the hinges and steaming in early sun. Now these chests, treasure chests, were open at the hinges. Hinges means joints. So they were open at the hinges and they lay steaming in the sun. They could feel that the steam of the sun or the heat of the sun was falling on this treasure chest. So that's it for today. The next part of this lesson will be taught in the next class. Hope you have understood. Thank you.